Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. We had a quake watch for the previous time frame, and as you can see on the SGI graph, with earthquakes magnitude 5.5 and stronger, we don't see a really strong or major seismic event, still no large earthquake, but we do see a seismic response pretty much where we expected it to occur. That was around the 3rd, 4th of November after the lunar conjunction with Uranus, and we had a 5.8 at the Andranov Islands, Aleutian Islands. And then after the lunar geometry with Jupiter, that's the high green peak on the end of the 4th, early 5th, we see a real cluster of stronger earthquakes in the higher 5 magnitude range still. And we also had a 6.2 off the coast of Iceland, Chile, southern Chile, and that was on the 8th after the lunar conjunction with Mars. So we had 3 lunar conjunctions and we had 3 times a seismic response. But if we look at the critical geometry that I pointed to early on in November, we don't see an obvious seismic response there. And that begs the question, where are the strong and major earthquakes? If you look at some statistics, because that's worth looking at right now. If you look at 6.4 and larger earthquakes, and we look at average of the last 5 years from 2019 to 2023, we know that we have a magnitude 6.4 earthquake on average about 7.4 days. So every 7.4 days, we should have on average a 6.4. But that's, of course, average. That's theory. That's not reality. We know that stronger earthquakes don't occur on average. But if we look at this year, we see that since January, it is somewhat below average with 9.8 days. And more dramatically, much more dramatically, since August, that's also the last time we had a magnitude 7 earthquake, we see a drop of stronger earthquakes, 6.4 and larger, 12.4 days, that's almost half of what we should see normally on average. And this has been the trend since August. So we have earthquake warnings, we have quake watches. We know the type of planetary geometry, lunar geometry that can trigger larger earthquakes. But the trend currently is that we only see earthquakes up until magnitude 6, borderline 6 magnitude, higher 5 magnitude range, typically like we had on around the 6th. But no major earthquakes. So the question is, when will larger earthquakes resume? We don't know. It depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust, but there may be other factors here as well, because we're now almost 3 months without a magnitude 7 earthquake, and we are almost half the average of magnitude 6.4 at larger earthquakes. It's not unprecedented, because in 2018, we had, that was when Hawaii was erupting, the volcanic activity at Hawaii. You may remember that from May to early August. There has been no magnitude 6.5 or larger earthquake in all those 3 months, and only 2 6.4 earthquakes in July of 2018. And we know that time ended in August 2018 with a magnitude 8 earthquake, 8.2, and I think was below Tonga. So we can have extended periods of seismic lull periods with no stronger earthquakes, no 6.4, no 6.5 or larger, and certainly magnitude 7 earthquakes. We can have half a year without magnitude 7 earthquakes, like in 2017, for example. So it's not unprecedented, but this is certainly something to look into. So let's have a look at the next time frame quickly here, up until the 18th of November. We're going to point out the planetary geometry that can potentially trigger larger earthquakes, with emphasis on potential. So we have today Earth, Venus, Neptune, right angle geometry, and its counterpart Venus, Earth, Neptune will be on the 11th. And Venus, Earth, Neptune right angle, that is a critical one. That's a critical right angle geometry that can result in a major earthquake. And then we're talking about 12, 13th. In January, we had this geometry, and in 1 day, we had a magnitude 7 earthquake in China. And it can also go larger. But this is the geometry on the 11th, so 12, 13th. Keep that in mind. Then we have a planetary conjunction, the next planetary conjunction, Mercury, Venus, Saturn, that can result in a seismic response. And then we're going to have a full moon on the 15th, early 16th, And that happens to coincide with a lunar conjunction with Uranus almost at the same time. There's only 3 hours in between. That's why we see a very high green peak and also the blue peak. That's the full moon. And that can result, because of the involvement of Uranus, it can result in a major seismic event around the time of full moon. But we also see Earth, Moon, Jupiter within 1.5 days. And we need to factor in that geometry as well. So it is possible that an obvious seismic response will not happen until around the 19th of November because of this lunar geometry with Jupiter. But keep in mind the full moon with Uranus within 3 hours, it's a real tight convergence there. That can be an obvious seismic response. It can easily reach magnitude 7, and in a worst case scenario, really worst case scenario, magnitude 8. And speaking of which, we haven't seen magnitude 8 earthquakes since August 2021. And they occur on average, there we go again, on average, about every year, a magnitude 8 earthquake, but that's not happening. More than 3 years now, we haven't seen a magnitude 8 earthquake. So it could be right around the corner, and this could be a magnitude 8 earthquake trigger around the time of full moon because of the involvement of Uranus. Whether or not it's going to happen, again, it very much depends on the stress levels in Earth's crust and when this extended low period is going to end. It could be in the coming time frame. And we have two options there. In the solar system, we see the right angle geometry. These are purple lines with Venus, Earth, and Neptune. And it will be followed by a lunar conjunction also with Neptune on the 12th. And counting from that lunar conjunction with Neptune, that's on the 12th, around the 13th, there is the potential for an obvious seismic response. We see Mercury, Venus, and Saturn, that's the red line, in a conjunction, and that will be on the 14th. And we see the three lines, that's red, that is green, and also blue, because of the full moon and the involvement of Uranus. That's the critical geometry that's going to happen later on the 15th, early 16th. And we could see an obvious seismic response around the time of full moon. But again, we have Jupiter coming up on the 18th, or let's say the 17th, and we could see a seismic response as a whole around the 19th. There's uncertainty there. If we look at atmospheric fluctuations, we see, this is from yesterday, over the Pacific, that's the Kuril Islands, and to the south, the Loyalty Islands, the Vanuatu, that region that relatively frequently experiences major earthquakes. But again, since August, we haven't seen any magnitude 7 earthquake, and also north of New Zealand, Kermadec Islands region. We also had over Asia fluctuations, again marking some region. It's been 70 years, over 70 years, 74 years now, that there has been a really large earthquake. In 1950, there was a magnitude 8.6. We may easily forget when there were so many years between. It could be right around the corner. So keep in mind, there is the potential in some region for a really large earthquake. And also South America, recently we had a 6.2, like I said, in southern Chile. And it's been a while since there has been large seismic activity in Chile, central southern part. And also to the north, that's Venezuela and the Caribbean plate near Puerto Rico. There is the potential according to these atmospheric fluctuations. Check out the website for the latest updates and also our social media channels for the latest updates in the coming time frame. This is the update for now. Stay safe. Until next time.